Hey everybody, so we're casting Katz's silicone skin right now. So I'm using smooth-on silicone pigment. So I used white, electric green, and the blue. And I came up with this color here, which is pretty darn close to this image of Katz here. So I tinted A and B because I didn't like how translucent it was, right? Because I'm using Dragon Skin 10 fast, so it's at 8 minute working time, about an hour and a half demold time. I tinted B, did a test with just part A tint, B just clear. It came out a little too translucent, so I went ahead and tinted B also. They're fairly close in color, a little different, but when I mix them up together, it'll be like a nice consistent color for everything. So this will be his skin. So this is part A and part B. I really like this color. And again, this is Dragon Skin 10 Fast. So we're running the ears and little components on his face first. So I washed the mold out with soap and water after we opened it and cleaned it out. I then sprayed it with Mold Release Man 200, silicone mold release. And we're gonna be brushing up layers of platinum silicone skin. Hit the main spots, eyes, nose, detail area, and they're gonna make thicker batches and make it a nice thick skin. And they're gonna line it with terry cloth so that there's something that can grab onto the rigid foam we're gonna put in there later. Line it with terry cloth, make a big old cake batch for the seam, close the mold, seal it up, and then we're gonna fill it with rigid foam. Slosh it around so we have a hollow rigid foam head that we can then mount around our armature, which you will see later. But that's all the prep I did for the mold. I have my epoxy eyes in here. We drilled and threaded holes in the epoxy eyes that we cast already. So this'll give us a perfect eye sphere negative spaces that we'll then put our glass or our resin eyes in. So we'll have nice big full sockets that'll work really well. So we're casting around those balls, and then when we demold, we'll just unscrew and pop the head out with those epoxy balls still inside. And then we'll spritz some 99% alcohol in there and pop them out and have perfect ball sockets. This is a material called 1630, which is just a mixable epoxy resin. So we did a block mold for the ears, both ears and lip separately. This is one ear cast, and you could see that the silicone is already starting to set up and get thick. But it was just too translucent for my taste. I wanted it a little bit more opaque, so we're still gonna probably use this ear. It'll just be a little off, but we'll match it with paint. But I'm getting second ear prepped now. Done with the tint, so I can start putting that away. You don't wanna get the stuff on your hand, that's the worst. So let's clean off the bottles and then put the caps on, throw the stir sticks away. Sorry for the sporadic updates on Katz also. It's really hard to just set up these cameras and start filming on every single step because I'm working on this thing 3 in the morning, you know, just as I feel like it, I'm working on it. And when I feel like working doesn't always mean I feel like setting up the camera and filming all of this and talking to it. So I'm gonna be doing a lot of, I'm trying to do like a lot of filming and voiceover stuff for some of the steps I missed. But this is still, if you have any questions, email me and I'll inform you on stuff and techniques and materials. But we're still covering basically all the basics. So for ear number two, also since we're working with platinum silicone, I'm using vinyl gloves. You don't, latex is the biggest issue with platinum. It'll inhibit it, it won't set up, it'll just stay gooey. So always have a clean area you're working with, always use vinyl gloves, not latex gloves. Just constantly be aware of contaminants that may be used into the silicone. Dragon Skin 10 is 1:1 by weight or volume, so we're just going off of volume here. So for, I did about 12 drams and it was too much for the tiny ear. So let's just do 8 drams. This is a bigger ear. Yeah, let's just do 10 drams of A and B. These are just little cuppies, little wax cuppies I got at Reynolds. All right, let's see how that looks. Set it down on the level surface. All right, and that's looking more like 12. That's all right. We'll do 12. Let's see, where is it? And I am not vacuuming out this silicone at all. Since we're doing brush ups on anything, we're just gonna be introducing bubbles into this thing like crazy anyways. So it's kind of pointless. The bubbles will work themselves out. And again, we have like 7 minutes working time, 8 minutes working time. So I've never worked with this fast before, but I like the idea of stuff moving fast, because when you're doing a brush up of silicone, nothing's worse than like chasing it for an hour while it's just drippy dripping all the time. So that's our final color, both A and B tinted. I like that. That's much better. We're gonna do a thin stream high up. Kind of clears the bubbles out. There we go. But yeah, we're doing these tiny parts, so we're just establishing the final color of the skin. Because you don't want to start brushing up on the face and then be like, oh, the skin looks weird, and then have like weird miscolored things, right? It's much easier to just scrap in here and try again. All right, so that's filling up. So let's kind of just rock it a bit. Look at that big bubble coming out. Perfect. That's what you want to see. Also, I also filled the seams with clean clay, just in case there's any like leaks or anything. I mean, that bubble could have easily been just space from the seam lines. Now, the amount of material in there, the weight compresses the air, so it's good to have kind of like top it off so there's like a lot of some more pressure of material pushing down, you know what I mean? All right, I think that's good. So let's set that aside, and in an hour and a half we'll be able to demold that, see how it looks. Silicone for Katz's skin right now. So we just measured equal parts A and B. Now this is Dragon Skin 10, which is like super fast silicone. It's 8 minute working time. But since we're doing the main skin on here, we gotta freaking vacuum it out. So, I'm mixing it now. Let's vacuum this out. 171 part B.
Ah. Yeah. It's a boy!
It's a boy!
Look at this ugly motherfucker!
There we go.
Damn!
Slap him!